That's a really good question.
I thought about wearing it. Wow. You know, like bling.
Thank you.
No, you're not.
Frank Castle is in my bones. You know, like Frank Castle is in my bones.
And the things that I saw in him and that he saw in me too.
Ryan, there was a lot of mystery and intrigue with Paul Mullen's one-year contract. Just curious if you could say if it was more or less than the projected budget for Deadpool 3.
Well, you have to take that up with Kevin Feige. Deadpool 1's budget was just, spit and about 58 cents. I think it's interesting that you even bring that up, because I think there is actually a tangible parallel there, which is that I think that great things happen when there are constraints. You know, typically, what murders creativity in my mind, at least, is when there's too much time and too much money. You know, and when you're operating, at least when you're trying to create an operation in the National League with a club like Wrexham, you know, you have to look at it in a sustainable way. So you're not looking to like put your finger on a scale that's just obscene in some way, but you are looking to build out a team that you can actually maintain and sustain for a long period. You're trying to sort of create a model there. That's not too dissimilar to how we looked at Deadpool. You know, every kind of barrier we were up against, every moment the studio took away money that we needed for our budget, you know, we found ways to turn that into lemonade. And that's kind of how we've been approaching at least this project, certainly.